Hi! In this 123 Tune Plus app tutorial, we're going to introduce you to the basic app functionality. The first time you open the app, a GPS permission dialog can appear. This GPS is used to display your car speed. Tap on Always Allow. Now go to Settings. Make sure your ignition key is switched on to power the 123 ignition. After it is powered and Bluetooth on your device is on, a 123 Tune should appear under Devices. Tap on it to connect. If it is the first time you connect to the ignition with this device, you have to enter the PIN code. The default PIN code is 1234. After you are connected, it is possible to activate the immobilizer as anti-theft function. As long as the immobilizer is on, the ignition will only fire a couple sparks. When connected, it is also possible to change the ignition PIN code. In this example, we will change the PIN code to 1234. You need to enter the new PIN code twice as a check. The other settings can be changed without being connected, like changing from metric to imperial or when you have a 6-volt battery instead of a 12-volt. Now go back to the dashboard to see actual engine information. This information includes battery voltage, ignition temperature and device speed based on GPS. When the engine runs, you can see the coil current, RPM, vacuum pressure and crankshaft advance. The crankshaft advance is based on current RPM and vacuum pressure. The advanced maps can be changed at curves. Make sure you are connected so you can read the curve from the ignition. If you do not know if you are connected, then go to settings and make sure that you see a 123 tune under devices with a check mark next to it. When you go to the curve tab, the current curve from the ignition will be read automatically. It is also possible to tap on the read button. Now it is time to change this curve. We will use an original Bosch curve as example. 1-2-3 ignition uses crankshaft RPM and advanced data, so please make sure your curve data is given in crankshaft RPM and advanced. When your data is given in distributor RPM and advanced, the values need to be doubled. To change the advanced curve and maximum RPM, scroll down to Centrifugal curve and tap on the Edit Centrifugal curve button. If you want to limit the maximum RPM of your engine, change the maximum RPM value. Above this value, the ignition will skip sparks to limit the RPM. Most curves have a tolerance which is indicated by two lines, as you can see in the curve example. It is best to take the middle of the two lines. We also need to convert the points to crankshaft RPM and advance by multiplying all values by 2. For the RPM curve, we have the following points. Point 1 is 0 degrees at 600 RPM, which converts to 0 degrees at 1200 RPM. Point 2 is 4.5 degrees at 750 RPM, which converts to 9 degrees at 1500 RPM. Point 3 is 12 degrees at 1900 RPM, which converts to 24 degrees at 3800 RPM. We will now add these points to the advanced curve in the ignition. The lowest point in the curve is always 500 RPM and the highest point is always 8000 RPM. To change a point, tap on the RPM and enter the desired value. This can also be done with the advanced value. You can add extra curve points with a maximum of 10 by tapping on the Add Point button on the bottom. If you want to remove the point, simply tap the Delete icon next to it. The last advance point is also added at 8000 RPM to keep this advance at high RPMs. When you are finished editing, tap on Done on top of the screen. It is time to change the vacuum curve. Scroll down and tap on Edit Map Curve. In the past, most car brands used millimeters of mercury for vacuum values. 123 ignition uses kilopascal values. You need to multiply the millimeter of mercury value by 0.133 to get the kilopascal value. 0.1 is 0 degrees at 80 millimeters of mercury, which converts to 0 degrees at 11 kilopascal. 0.2 is 5 degrees at 190 millimeters of mercury, which converts to 10 degrees at 25 kilopascal. Please be aware that these vacuum values are only converted from distributor advance to crankshaft advance and from millimeters of mercury to kilopascal. The converted pressure values are still relative to atmospheric pressure instead of absolute pressure values. You need to subtract the value from the atmospheric pressure, which is 100 kilopascal at sea level. For the first point, we need to enter 100 minus 11, which is 89 kilopascal. For the second point, we need to enter 100 minus 25, which is 75 kilopascal. The 100 kilopascal point in the ignition is fixed to 0 degrees advance and cannot be changed. All values below the 100 kilopascal are advance points. All values above 100 kilopascal are retard points and need to be negative. MAP retard will only be used in case of turbo engines. When you are finished, please tap on the done button. The curve has now been changed but is not stored in the ignition yet. Tap on the right button to store the curve into the ignition. It is also possible to store the curve on your phone or tablet by pressing on the save file button. If a file name was not yet specified, you will see a dialog where you can enter a file name. The curve will be saved under this name. If you would like to open a saved curve, tap on Files. Now tap on the curve you need and then tap on Open. The curve is now opened. You can edit this curve and save it or write this curve to the connected ignition.